Complexity theory deals a lot with problems and with algorithms. So we should say a little bit more about each one of the two. So a problem normally consists of three parts. The first one is very simple. It's just a name that we give to the problem so that when we talk about it, we know how to reference it. And in this case, we're going to find a better name for that soon, but in this case, we'll just call the problem that Alice was working on Alice's problem. For each problem, we also need to say something about the input that we're expecting for it. So in this case here, it's a network of communication centers. And of course, we also need to say something about the output that we are expecting. So in this case here, it would be the minimum number of monitoring devices to cover all cables or all connections. Of course, the most useful output would be to know not only the minimum number of monitoring devices, but where we should actually put them. But you're soon going to see that it doesn't really make much of a difference most of the time if we're just asking for the minimum number or if we're actually asking for the communication centers where we need to put those devices. Now, what Alice devised to solve this problem was a possible algorithm. Now, there's no really accepted definition of what an algorithm actually is, but for us, it's enough to say that whenever we talk about an algorithm, we'll be talking about the description of a computer program that is able to solve the problem that we're given. Now, the question that we want to answer for Alice's problem, since the algorithm that she has found is not very good, is if the problem that she's working on is a hard problem or an easy problem. And what we mean by that is if it's possible to find a more efficient algorithm for this problem. If that is the case, then we would call this problem an easy problem, or we will soon have a more precise definition of that, actually. And if it's not possible to find a better algorithm for the problem, then this would be considered a hard problem. Now, the hardness of a problem tells you how fast and with how many resources you can solve the problem, but of course that would require you to find the best possible algorithm for that problem. And best is not a very scientific term, so we'll have to say a little bit more about the analysis of algorithms.